Good morning, everyone. I hope you all are in the best of your health and mood. The topic for today's video is the unification of Italy. We have already covered the unification of Germany, and today we will be discussing how did Italy get unified, or let's say how did Italy become a nation state. So let's start. This is the map of Italy that you see in front of you. Before the unification, Italy was divided into several different states. Here you can see that Italy has been divided into four different parts: part 1, part 2, part 3 and the part 4. Okay, so here you see that Italy has been divided into four different parts. However, Italy was actually divided into seven different states. But we do not talk about all the seven states here, but instead we will talk about the four major different parts Italy was divided into. The first part is the northern part of Italy that was ruled by the Habsburg Austrian Empire. Then, in the center, we have the Central Italy, ruled by Pope. And so, the Central Italy was also known as the Papal State. We then have the third part, also called the southern part of Italy. Or let's say, we can also call it the Kingdom of Two Sicilies. And that part was ruled by the Bourbon King of Spain. So, we see the first, second and the third parts are ruled by three different monarchs, and none of these monarchs are actually Italian. But then we have one part of Italy, the fourth part, called the Sardinia Piedmont, and that part of Italy was ruled by an Italian king and hence was called the Italian princely house. We then move on to our next slide. This slide contains all the details of the political fragmentation of Italy that we just now discussed. So if you all want, you can take a screenshot of it. Okay. So we now move on to the important people of Italy who played a major role in the unification of Italy. First and foremost, we talk about an Italian revolutionary. His name was Giuseppe Mazzini. He was a revolutionary person. He also formed secret societies, and one of his secret societies that became very popular was the Young Italy. That society was formed to fulfill all his goals of unification of Italy. But then all his uprisings, all the revolutions that he did were failed. The second important person was King Victor Emmanuel II. This King Victor Emmanuel II was the king of the Italian princely house Sardinia Piedmont that we just now discussed. King Victor Emmanuel took the responsibility of unification of Italy as he saw there a possibility of economic development. He thought that if he plays a major role in the unification of Italy, then it will not only bring economic development but also will bring him political dominance. The third important person we talk about is Cavour. Cavour was the chief minister of Sardinia Piedmont. The chief minister had really good relations with France. That means he, you know, the book says that he could speak French much better than Italian. That is telling us that he had really good connections with France. And so, with the help of France, or let's say that through an alliance with France, Sardinia Piedmont succeeded in defeating the northern part of Italy in 1859 that was ruled by the Habsburg Austrian Empire. The last person we talk about was Giuseppe Garibaldi. Do not confuse it with the first person, Giuseppe Mazzini. He is the other one, Giuseppe Garibaldi. In 1816, Giuseppe Garibaldi marched to southern part of Italy, and with the help of all the local peasants there whom he motivated, they all together won over the Bourbon King of Spain, and then they drove the Spanish rulers out of Italy. Finally, in 1861, Italy got unified, and King Victor Emmanuel II was proclaimed the king of the unified Italy. You can see in the map in front of you that now all of the Italy is colored with only one color, and there are no different states now in Italy. Instead, this is the picture of the unified Italy in 1861. I hope you all understand the complete process of unification of Italy. So this will be all for the day. Thank you and have a great day.